I went to Thailand and Cambodia on the first trip in 2008, 3 weeks. And I went to Vietnam and Thailand, second trip in 2009, for another 3 weeks. So really just a glimpse of Southeast Asia. Just a glimpse. And when I went, even though I'm a lifelong photographer, it wasn't in my mind to necessarily make an exhibit. I wanted to live and breathe the experience of being there. That was my purpose. And whatever else happened would be fine. But of course, within about 5 minutes, I was taking pictures because I can't help it. I was so sparked right away when I got there. I had always photographed for a long time, had photographed in a way that was a very meditative, long, slow process on a tripod. I got off my tripod. I was shooting on the fly, photographing glimpses and moments and impressions. And I was loving it. And I was so awakened by it. I was so awake and alert when I was there. I knew that I had been changed by those trips. And I wanted so much to be able to somehow share that experience with others, somehow make images that held some piece of what it was that I had experienced. The first thing I did was to start to string the images together. And I realized very quickly that was working. They had the energy and the intensity, the dynamic, the vitality that reflected my experience. And then I also was imagining, I started to imagine more of a collaging effect. Collages are really built. They have layers. These were just going to be images next to one another. So they were really photo montages rather than collages. It was not my intention to work with alternative materials. I wasn't saying to myself, now I'm going to do something new. But I was pushed. I was being pushed by this very other experience I'd had to do something different. I used silk and ended up using silk organza and rice paper. And I love the fact that the inks, the colors were a little degraded, just a little, on the rice paper. And I gravitated to using them for these montages I made of Vietnam, because in Vietnam was a little more subdued. The culture was more subdued, or my experience of the culture was more subdued. I felt like the rice paper was the right medium. When I started thinking about silk, I was like, oh, this is so perfect, because it moves, it's free, it's unencumbered, it shifts. The energy that I felt, both internally and what I was witnessing in these countries, was not static. It wasn't still. It was dynamic and active and so alive that using material that could move felt like exactly the right thing to do. The silk organza was translucent enough, not so translucent that it wouldn't hold an image on its own, but translucent enough that I could see through it to beyond to another image, and I was very excited about that. My experience of Southeast Asia was of a very rich and complex and deep and layered cultures. And there seemed to be a lot that was unknowable, mysterious. So I liked the film, the sense of looking through, of trying to see into, of the organza. And yet at the same time, while I felt this sort of veiled quality about being in these really rich, deep cultures, they also revealed themselves really easily. Life was out in the open. We were in the tropics. Everything is outside. You know, my experiences there were so immediate and so visceral. I didn't want to frame anything. I wanted the people who were seeing these images to be able to have something of that too, by not having to see through some layer, not have them dimmed by glass, and not have them boxed in. And at first I thought I was just going to tack the prints up on the wall, very casually. But I also began to understand when I finally hung the exhibit and realized that it had gradually morphed from a very casual kind of notion about how this was going to look to something that had more of a presence and a formality, that it seemed just right because it was honoring appropriately these beautiful cultures that I had been in, and it was respectful of them and these unique and really special gifts that they are offering the rest of the world. And that changed my life forever.